Okay, good morning, one are present here. I am Dr. E. Rangarajan, Professor of Computer Science Department from the College of Veltech Manitech, Dr. Rangarajan, Dr. Samsara Engineering College. Today we will discuss the topic about the training and the public key, cryptography and RSA algorithm. So first we will discuss about what is private key encryption. So before discussing the private key encryption, basically encryption is nothing but you can transfer the data from plain text to ciphertext. So you can transfer the data from plain text to ciphertext is referred as encryption, and then you can transfer the data from ciphertext to plain text is referred from decryption. So first we will discuss about what is private key encryption. Traditionally private key, single key or secret key is always known as the single word of private key. The key was shared both the sender and the receiver. If the key is disclosed, the communication is compromised. So anywhere you can share the keys. And also private key is known as symmetric. Then public key encryption. The another name for public key encryption is asymmetric. And then also it is named as two key encryption. One for public key, another for private key. Here public key, you can anybody, and it can be used to encrypt the messages and also verify the signature. In the private key point of view, only the recipient know about the particular key. It is also used to decrypt the messages, and also it is named as signed signature. So these are the data transportation between source and destination using public key encryption. In this example, I already said the plain text has input variable, and then the input is sent to the encryption algorithm. Example of either RSA algorithm or AES algorithm, whatever it may be, Bluefish algorithm, lot of algorithms available. So here the input has a plain text. Then here in the sender side, the public key was shared. So public key from public key, then it was transferred to the data was transferred into ciphertext. In the destination side, one of the algorithm is available, decryption algorithm. So that particular decryption algorithm is inversion of encryption. Then you will get the plain text. The another concept for public key is crypto system. In the crypto system, it is a two-way encryption methodology. So one encryption for public key, another encryption for private key, like this. So this is source or client, whatever it may be. The input as a messages is sent to encryption algorithm. In the first encryption algorithm, the key was shared using the private key. So the key pair, you can get the key value from the key pair source, private key. Then second encryption shared with the public key. Then after the encryption, the data is sent to destination. In the destination, vice versa, or whatever we are doing in the encryption side. Then these are the list of three important applications available. One is encryption, decryption, second one is digital signature, third one is key exchange. So one of the suitable example, we will discuss about the RSA algorithm. It was launched from reversed Shamir Adelman from MIT in the year of 1977. It is suitable for public key scheme. And then also the RSA algorithm is based upon the exponential value in a finite field over integration modulo plane. How we can calculate the exponential value means order of three times of log n. So this is an easy operation methodology. And also the maximum of 1024 bits was transferred during the data transformation. Then, apart from the exponential, one more factorization is available. That factorization operation is order of e power log n, log and log n. Then, how to generate the key using RSA algorithm? So this is the methodology followed inside the RSA algorithm. So first, each and every user generating the public key and then private key. Here I will explain how to generate the public key and the private key. First you should select it to prime number. So that particular prime number you can select it randomly. Take it prime number A, Then computing the value, model is n. So you can calculate it from prime number p and q. So n is equal to p into q. Then pi of n, you should calculate pi of m. Pi of m should be p minus 1 multiplied with q minus 1. Then select the encryption, random encryption key. A key value as e. That particular key value should be between 1 and then pi of n. So pi already you are calculated as pi of n. So pi of n is based upon the input variable p and then q. That particular encryption key should be between 1 and then pi of n. Then calculate the GCD value. So GCD of e comma pi of n is equal to 1. So after the encryption key, then we should choose the decryption key D value. So that the particular D value should be satisfying this condition. So D should be between 0 to 1 n. E multiplied with D is equal to 1 modulus pi of n. So finally, public key encryption key is public key of E comma n. Then private key is D comma P comma Q. So it depends upon the input variable. So public key is calculated based upon the E value and then F value. Private key which depends upon the D value, P value and then Q value. Then this is the calculation. How to compute the RSA encryption? In the RSA encryption, C value is equal to M power E modulus N. Then M value equal to C power D modulus N. Then I will explain it to another simple example. In the RSA algorithm, let us take us two prime numbers, p is equal to 17 and then q is equal to 11. So based upon your input variable, first you should calculate the n value. So n is equal to p into q. So 17 multiplied with 11, you will get the value of 187. Then again you should compute pi of n. So pi of n is equal to p minus 1 multiplied with q minus 1. So 16 multiplied with 10, 160. Then we should choose any one of the e value. Here I am choosing the value as 7. The 7 should be between 0 to pi of n, like I said. So the GCD of e comma 160 should be equal to satisfying with the value of 1. So that's why I am choosing the value e is equal to 7. Then again we should determine the value of d. So based upon the formula, e multiplied with d is equal to 1 modulus 160. So here I am choosing the value of d is equal to 23. So public key is based upon 7 and 187. Private key is based upon 23, 17 and then 11. Then I am applying the encryption formula. Here the input variable is m is equal to 88. So you can apply this first encryption. So already I said encryption is a ciphertext conversion. So c is equal to 88 power 7 modulus 187. You will get the value of ciphertext value of 11. Then again in the decryption, you can apply the vice versa of your encryption. 11 power 23 modulus 187 is equal to 88. So whatever you get the input variable, you will get the same value using the RSA algorithm. So you have any query about the RSA algorithm public key, you contact us regularly at veltechmultitech.org. My contact number is 80561 33788.